piranha, voracious flesh-eating fish common to warm water climes, attacking in schools of hundreds. Their razor-sharp teeth can strip a man to the bone in less than a minute. You are now in the deep end of horror.
All right, let's see those pearly whites.
I'm a piranha. They're in the Amazon.
And
five is right out.
Sleek, fierce, savage, deadly, the piranha.
Piranha 2, the spawning. First, let me start by saying that this is a terrible movie. Director James Cameron is quite right in his quote that Piranha 2 is the best flying piranha movie ever made. He was fired partway into filming, but his name remains on the credits. This is a guilty pleasure. It is generally a given that any horror movie will have an annoying character in it that you want to see disposed of. In this stinker, essentially everyone except the female lead and the police chief played by the wonderful Lance Henriksen is ridiculously annoying and is a very good reason to hate the film. If you strip away all the extraneous characters, this is a fun romp, so essentially a half hour of fun sandwiched into an hour and a half movie. Male lead Steve Marichuk only appeared in two other movies, so this did his career no favors. The female lead Trisha O'Neill is best known for playing Woman on Titanic. Check it out on IMDb. I normally never recommend this, but this would be one to watch the action sequences and play Candy Crush when the annoying people are on. It's a lot of fun, but only if you don't pay attention to the non-piranha scenes.
They bred the ultimate killing machine. Now, you're not safe out of the water. Piranha 2, Flying Killers.
The Pirates of Blood River. Though they remain mostly unseen and are more of a plot device than anything else, this is the first use I've seen of piranhas in the movies. This 1962 pirate adventure from Hammer Studios features a post-Sinbad Kerwin Matthews as our conflicted hero, but of course the real draw is Christopher Lee as the pirate Captain La Roche. And unlike most actors, Lee was actually an expert swordsman and fencer. Oliver Reed has an early role here as one of the pirates, and he and Lee would reteam a decade and a half later for the swashbucklers The Three and Four Musketeers. The piranha scenes were originally much gorier, but were cut along with several other scenes as well as some sexual language to get a more family-friendly rating. Hammer regular Andrew Keir plays Kerwin Matthews' father, even though he's actually younger than Matthews. The pirates travel overland because Hammer could not afford a pirate ship, having destroyed their pirate ship in the last pirate movie that they made by accident. And the hardest working man in Hammer, Michael Ripper, the man who is in more Hammer movies than anyone else, is the pirate Mac, and there he is on the left.
Also starring Marla Landy in a swashbuckling adventure as big as a screen can hold.
Mr. Hensh, you will see to it that no one remains alive.
Guard the door! No one is to escape!
Three shall be the number thou shalt count, and the number of the counting shall be three.
My first exposure to James Bond was seeing Diamonds Are Forever at the Base Theater as a little kid, so Sean Connery will always be my Bond. Shortly after that, still growing up, I saw You Only Live Twice when it premiered on television. Little Marc was blown away. I knew about Bond, but I'd never seen judo, ninja, sumo, piranha, or much of Japan. This movie helped inspire a lifelong interest in Japanese history and culture. Rewatching it now, You Only Live Twice from 1967, is not a very good Bond film. I love Sean Connery as 007, but by this point Connery's Bond had become a parody of himself, and the film did not age well. It's wildly misogynistic, and if that wasn't problematic enough for you, Bond becomes Japanese in this film, and yes, I'm using my air quotes. Still, it is a fun romp for the secret agent through Japan and meeting his equivalents in their secret service at the time. The giant volcano base was the largest interior set ever constructed in Europe, and the helipad and monorail seen in the movie are real and actually work. Depending on your preferences, the highlight of You Only Live Twice is either the indoor pool of piranha for disposing of unworthy henchmen, or the delightful, if short, performance of Donald Pleasance as Ernst Stavro Blofeld. For you young whippersnappers, that would be the model for Dr. Evil in the Austin Powers series. Interestingly, Charles Gray from Rocky Horror Picture Show has a small part here as Henderson, but would play Ernst Stavro Blofeld in Connery's next outing as Bond, Diamonds Are Forever. Writer Roald Dahl captured the essence of Bond, yet much of the film is anti-Bond. Bond dies, gets married, changes racial identity, doesn't drive a car, though he does fly an awesome gyrocopter, doesn't wear a tuxedo, and most egregiously, drinks a martini that's stirred, not shaken. Other than that, the movie is rather formulaic, albeit entertaining, even though it differs radically from the book. The producers wanted Frank Sinatra for the title song, but since he was not available, Nancy Sinatra, whose boots were definitely made for walking, provides the excellent vocal for the classic title song.
Tiger said, from now on, you must do everything in Japanese style.
Everything?
My number two man, his name? Number two.
Piranha 3D from 2010 just barely missed the cut as my favorite Piranha film. Perhaps if I had seen it in its 3D glory, that would have given it the nudge it needed. Alexandre Aja does an excellent job of remaking Joe Dante's classic 1978 film while pushing the R rating as far as it will go. Basically, this remake of Piranha helps redefine the term over the top. Aja concentrates on keeping it fun while amping up the gore, sexual situations, and nudity. Not counting the reasons for the R rating, Elizabeth Shue is the star here, and she appears to have quite a bit of fun with the part. The female law enforcement lead really works, as much of the rest of the film is about exploiting women. Ving Rhames ably plays her tough guy deputy, though his character isn't given much depth until a great scene during the climax. Richard Dreyfuss has a hysterical cameo at the beginning of the film as someone who definitely needs a bigger boat. Jerry O'Connell plays the obligatory, thoroughly annoying character, a thinly veiled parody of the Girls Gone Wild founder, who needs to die horribly and is marvelously smarmy and amoral. Christopher Lloyd is our wild-eyed scientist who provides the necessary exposition. Like Joe Dante did in the original film, Aja also packs in even more known faces, Adam Scott, Dina Meyer, Eli Roth, Greg Nicotero, and even some people from the porn industry.
We are number one. All others are number two or lower.
Lost River Lake. You'll find swimming, sailing...
The original Piranha from 1978 is naturally my favorite Piranha movie. It's a classic from Maestro Joe Dante. I really like that he openly acknowledges that it's a Jaws ripoff by starting the film with a female character playing the video game Jaws. Universal was in the process of suing to block Piranha, much like they did with the Last Shark, a.k.a. Great White. But Spielberg saw Piranha and called it the best of the Jaws ripoffs, and the suit, coincidentally or not, was dropped. John Sayles got his start here writing the screenplay, and the part I find most hysterical in the script is that while it's quickly glossed over, our female protagonist Maggie McCune, played by Heather Menzies, is the one who ultimately causes all the deaths in the movie after she appears. She is, in effect, the killer. Bradford Dillman stars as our antisocial hero with an alcohol problem, Paul Grogan. Dante did a fabulous job filling out the other roles with genre stalwarts Dick Miller, who has a larger part than normal, horror queen Barbara Steele, Keenan Wynn, Kevin McCarthy, Belinda Belaski, and Paul Bartel. Piranha is Rob Bottin's first credited makeup role. While he would later win an Oscar for Total Recall, his crowning achievement has to be John Carpenter's The Thing. This was an early role for special effects artist Phil Tippett as well. Here he's credited as creature designer and animator. Later, he was nominated for 6 Academy Awards and 1 for Return of the Jedi and Jurassic Park.
They're here, and they're hungry.